Come on, let's get to 100. Oh. Do you know what it means to feel like God? Do you? Do you? I've noticed that I have an absurd, almost disgusting amount of resources, these included. This episode's a tall order, but I think we can fill it. I've stayed away from the village for a long time, mostly procrastinating, mostly just putting it off. If I'm not procrastinating, I'm putting it off. And if I'm not putting it off... But anyways, I think that today we're going to finish the village. We're going to start it, we're also going to finish it. So, this is where the tree tunnel comes out, which means this is the area where the houses will be. So, I'm going to start with putting down some floor plans, and then I'll get back to you. Alright, so I put down some floor plans, and I'll just kind of walk you through what the whole thing is here. So this is the path that you walk in on him. So you walk in the room, and they're like, hey, what? And you go around here, and this lovely thing should kind of... trickle you down, or dump you down, or whatever. Just a light sliding down the road here. And once you get to here, it should be like, wow, I'm in a town. And when you walk through here, it should be like, boom, houses. So this is sort of a bit of a fancier house here. So it might actually be more than a house. And I also have one over there, but... I'll tell you about that in a little bit. I'm gonna get a better view. I'm gonna look from either on top of that over there, or just build this up. So this ring here is sort of the middle of the town, as was established back when all this terraforming and stuff was going on. So a little word on what I'm doing here. This is a little bit different than how I did everything over there. Over there, I had houses and I just kind of found spots for them. This time around, I'm making the spots go first, and then the houses later, I think. Anyways, I could have done this in two ways. I could have had a ring of houses going around the outside of this, so like this would be some sort of centerpiece, and then there'd be like a path going here, and then from that, it would sort of pinwheel off into like houses like that and like that. But I decided to go for a bit more of a meandering sort of main path that's going to go through kind of like this and kind of go up into some of these spots to reach these other houses. Just so it isn't... It looked almost too perfect before. It looked kind of weird, actually. I'm gonna tell you the truth on that one. So there's those. Also, if you're wondering about the shapes, how it looks like each of them is three triangle-type shapes that are all kind of clumped together, you are correct. I actually had a little bit of an experiment when building these. Is instead of designing a bunch of different types or having one type of just one house repeated over and over, I decided to have basically chunks of house, if that makes any sense. Like the biggest rectangle would be the living area, and then that could either be 3x7 on the inside, or 4x6 on the inside. And then there'd be a bathroom, which would be 3x3, and a bedroom, which would be 3x4. And I just kind of put them all into one house, sort of, like put those all basically touching each other, and kind of saw what happens. And actually, I got quite a few different types of things to show up. So that actually turned out being giving it a lot more variety than I thought. I guess another rule was that both of the smaller rooms had to touch the bigger room. So with stuff like this, or that, you'll notice all of these, and even this, they're like on either side right there. It's never like little, then slightly bigger than big. Big is always in the middle somehow. So the also these aren't going to be too crazy of a design of house. Like I didn't want them to be too fancy. Like these are just the how the homes, you know, the villagers and whatnot. These are the people that go off to work and all the various shops. I think I have about 10 of them out there. So I needed at least 10 of them. I think I ended up with 13. A good old lucky number. And not counting this one. So that'll be the 14th one. But this one I decided this one's kind of special. This is basically going to be where the founders and the runners and the operators of the town live, or operator, like. So basically the head kingpin dude or gal or whatever, I don't know. Lives there. They're going to have a little bit fancier house. We're going to see why later, but I actually this was the part that the reason why I had such kind of issue or trouble with this is that I didn't know if everyone should have the same house. And everyone just be like a social commune, an anarchistic social commune, or like have one that sort of runs the show. So I decided to go for a one that runs the show. And they're gonna have a little bit nicer place. So here's an up close look at these. Like I said, it's the inside is the 3x7 or 4x6 dimensions. So the outsides are sort of like corners with these. So I haven't really put in the doors or where those are yet, so that would be the next step, I suppose. So this isn't really too big of a deal. I'm probably just gonna make sure that there's a door in all of these, at least with like one space between any wall. So probably I'll do these first. So this could be a nice little neighborly area where they all kind of face inward. As far as inside, so for stuff like this, I could probably have the bathroom. That's the bathroom, and this is the bedroom. Wait a minute. As I was saying, oh, whoops. This is the bedroom, and this is the bathroom. So in order to get into these, I think I'm going to do something like this. Inside of each of these, you won't be able to tell the difference if there's a corner missing here. So I'm going to make that into sort of like a more of a walkway. So this is where that would be for this house. This one, I'm thinking, let's see, probably like this. I could probably do something like this. That'd be fine. And for here, this one's a little bit more straightforward. And so I'm just going to go around all of these and basically pick where the entrances should be. Like probably that and that. And then where the doors are that lead into the special areas. And by that I mean like the bedroom and the bathroom. Next after that is to take whatever block is on the bottom and bring it up three. So that would be like those or these. And that goes for the insides too. However, some of these are doorways. So when bringing them up, just make sure that the one above the gaps, three up above the gap, there's a block there. Also, I decided that the bedrooms should get at least one window, and the big areas in here should get all the windows that they want. So, you know, who am I to tell them that they can't, you know, have awesome windows? So, what I'll probably do is something like this. Have like maybe one window, 'cause too much is like, you know, come on. This is a bedroom. You don't have too many windows, you know. And the bathroom, I don't think it really needs to have any windows. It's just something I don't think that it has to have. So when all's said and done, or done's been said, I think I like that better. When all's done been said, should be looking like this. And then after these, stragglers get brought up. Comes the floor. And the floor, I think, is just going to be the opposite color of the walls. Considering that these are like opposites. So like if this is the wall, this color would be the floor. Or if this color is the wall, then this color would be the floor. And that's kind of what I'm doing out here. I also tried to make them not necessarily like alternating perfectly, because then everything would look like this. It almost does. But I want to have like pockets of not alternating, just to make it seem a little bit more random than if it was just like, oh, look at that checkerboard, you know. So you'll see when that's get back to you. This is what we got so far. They do look pretty similar, and that's because they are. I did vary things up in a couple ways though, like mix and matching the roof with the walls. You know, sometimes having the same, sometimes having them opposites. And the thing is, I always left the floor like this because I thought that looked nicer. Also, if a house ended up being floating above areas where there weren't a ground, I just put some ground there. I guess we'll figure out what to do with this. I don't know. I think there's going to be some more little things going on. And I'm not sure, actually. Maybe there'll be a few more things in here, like maybe like ponds and stuff. I don't know. I feel like I'm getting kind of inspired to do some more landscaping in here, which is good because it needs it. And, oh yeah, I wanted to show kind of what the roofs were. I just sort of threw them all up there and didn't really explain myself. So basically, I just make a trim. I skip the corners. So all the sides have the half slabs on the top. And it starts to look like this. The next part is to take everything that's in one and bring it up and with another half slab. And I even hit these corners too, just to, you know. And even if you don't know, now you know. Actually, you don't, because I didn't explain myself. I'm doing this partly to keep mobs from spawning on top of these roofs, because they're half slabs. What the? It seems that my mouse is stuck on the click option. Oh boy. I don't think I've ever had that happen before. That's troubling. As I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, this is going to keep mobs from spawning on top of these, although they can still spawn on these, so I'll have to be careful about lighting. I guess that'll come later. But I even do the insides. It's just a flat roof, nothing fancy. I kind of got not fancy for these. So that's the roof, but I didn't finish there because one that's all lit up on the inside and at nighttime, you get the strange shadows because they're just half slabs. So you find the door. And then what I did is I just put an extra layer of half slabs. Just did that for every room, and it was pretty good. And then last but not least, make sure the torches are in there, the jets fly over, and yeah, I pretty much did that. I know that they don't look... What I'm going to do to make them have a bit more personality is probably the way I decorate things later. One of the ways is probably just to make sure that you can't see all of them all the time. That's a fun way to do it. Just kind of, if you forget that there's so many of them that look alike. But I'm getting ahead of myself. I need to come over here now. It is nice though, going through here and seeing stuff actually is being built. I guess this is good. So these are going to be a little bit different. A little different places over here. The floor plan is pretty much ready. I just kind of leveled out a little bit of this. And actually, I kind of ran into remember the hollowed out parts. For those of you that don't know, this hill wasn't here originally. But if I put down dirt and put things on top of the, then it seems to be okay. So like if I need this to connect with that, I can just do that. And if the floor was, oh yeah, if the floor was half slabs, then you'd want dirt underneath it to keep the light from coming up. That's what I meant to say. I actually don't even know what I said. I'll have to go back and check that out. So for these, I'm gonna do kind of similar to the other buildings in the village. Is have these types of walls and windows. They kind of put a little, they kind of pop, give it a little bit more pop. Little more 3D going on. Think it makes the buildings look a little bit more or less mass-produced. Like more thought went into a building if it has more details like that. There's no real reason to have a window here, unless you want to look at dirt. So I'm just gonna do this the rest of the way like this. Just filling it in. For the floor, instead of doing the half slabs, because this is just like a fake floor anyways, I'm just gonna do whole pieces, just so don't have to worry about any of those weird shadow things. You know what I'm actually going to do is have some center support beams in here also. So just right where these kind of cross, and we'll see why in a little bit. So the roof time now. It's time to start the roof time. Oh, that's not a good way to start. Whatever, maybe actually it is. Maybe that was the smartest thing I could have done. This is basically going to go all the way across. It's going to be a bit of a trim though. So that's another stair on that side. And I'll hurry up and put one on this side. And this is going to have a nice little thing that comes down like this, all along the front. This is going to be a kind of a weird pattern, but I was messing around with it and I kind of liked it. It's going to be a brace like that. Just jump on over. A stair. Get back over here. Not too far. Too far back. Put another brace. Maybe I can just jump to it. Yes! And these. Actually, I could probably just do it from on top of here. Oh yeah, that's much easier. And I think at this point, I'm not sure. We'll see. Oh yeah, there's a post here. So I think this actually turns into this. In fact, yes, it does. It does. I'll just say it. And I'll put the trim on the outsides. Let's get that going nice and good. You gotta get it, got it good. And while I'm here, I might as well finish this design. Think it's gonna be just one in the front. So it's like this. So I think that might actually be a full block. I might be doing this the difficult way. Although, mind you, that's never stopped me in the past. Just jump down. This should be the same height as the other one, so one more. And let's get a top slab on that. Ooh, very good. And then one more for the road. A top slab right there. So if we jump down, yeah, I think that works pretty good. This might work better if there wasn't like the birch peeking through there, but I'm fine with that. Once we get the wall in. Oh, hey, look at that. It's looking all right. So I'm gonna do a mirror image of this on the other side. Woundaba or Wonderba. Now it's time to make a connection. So I'm gonna make a connection and really connect this side to that side. So I'm not gonna. These are gonna be kind of special at this level. So just where the wood is, whatever is here, just gonna bring it straight across. So, like, yeah, that looks pretty much like that. And yep, I might even go this one too, which means probably do that. And just that's the design that'll go across. I think it's appropriate to do the second floor now. I think it's just gonna be these. Pretty much everywhere. At this point, it's a lot easier to fill in the wall. Oh, yeah. These. Oh. There we go. So this part's gonna be interesting. I'm probably gonna do is, let's see, counting this one, five birch. So one, two, three, four, five. Do the same thing to the other side. So one, two, three, four, five. That. What I'm gonna go ahead and do is make this a little bit easier on myself. Make a little, a mini stairway thing right there. So the birch steps are going to go up that. And there should be like a three wide area here. So same thing here. And yeah. Three wide, good. The reason for the three wide is because I'm going to make a nice little window thing. So if I just do this, I take that out, and let's see, I can put these stairs in here. And a little half slab. That is a pretty good window, I think. Oh. The back ends up looking kind of like this, so I'll just, make that a little better by, know, maybe doing that. A window will eventually go in here. The only trouble is that since these are stairs, windows don't attach to them, or half slabs either, so it'll just be like a weird thing. So I need to use the glass cube to do that. At this point, I can bring the stairs up just like that on both sides. I believe it was. Yes, here. So three in, four in actually. Four in? So one, two, three, four. That's where that pillar continues from down below. Think just one more will. Oh, do it. Good thing you can't get concunks in this game. Concussions. By like jumping up and hitting the ceiling, like, oh. Otherwise, I'd have trouble a lot. I forgot to connect these. This had the lower part too, with the upper part. All right, how do I want to do this wall? I think I might just do a standard thing like this. That would actually be interesting to turn that into a balcony. I think I won't for now, though. And I guess I can get rid of these. Right, so it's like a window, or it is a window. I've boxed myself in. I can't get out. I'm gonna make access here via ladder on each of these sides. Oh, and the other reason I put these posts here is a good excuse for lighting. So I think, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, everything should be spawn proof in here. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, that might be a 7 right there. Oh well, I'll do that. A final tip or note, if you really don't feel comfortable building with birch, it seems to pair really nicely with cobblestone. Something as simple as that kind of helps that out. I'll put a little half slab action going on in here. Just to make sure things don't spawn. All right, this is the last structure, and then we'll be good. So, I don't know if I really showed the floor plan yet, but it's basically 7 by, and the last, so, yeah, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 7 by 14. And I think I wanted this to be log also, just to make it same, each of these logs is going to be 7 tall from here, so one that tall. At the fourth height, be little cross beams connecting everything like this, just in one big triangle. Rectangle, one big rectangle. This might come to a surprise, but come to a surprise, come as a surprise. I'm just gonna fill in this whole back wall, and even a lot of this. This building's actually gonna be a little bit, quite a bit different. A little bit, quite a bit different. Ooh, this is gonna be a double door. I just realized. Since I'm down here, I'm gonna work a little bit on these. There's gonna be some balcony type things going on. And nothing too crazy. Probably just this. That. And what? Gonna clean this up so it looks better eventually. So right now this fence is pretty useless, like, but thinking something like that. That's gonna be holding up the next area. And I'm gonna do that on the other side too. And in here, I think let's just let's start off with this. All the way until the stairs, and then continue on. And from the inside, looks kind of like this. From the outside, okay, I don't. Never mind. There's no good view here. Right, next layer gets a floor. How do I want to go upstairs? Ta-da! Think I can get away with a few more windows up here, so I'll do that. So each of these is gonna be like this. I think these will be. Let's see, the A-frame would be there. So, like that. Like that. Think that looks kind of cool. This actually looks really fancy for this village. Since I'm on the roof, I might as well get into the roofing business. I'm going to start off by setting the outline on the bottom. The outline on the bottom. There we go. Don't think I'll go really too fancy here. I don't think I have to. Probably just that. And then repeat. Let's see. All right, so this is going to end up being another A-frame right in the middle for both of those to complement the ones on the outside. To help with that, I'll probably enlist these extra blocks to make steps. So let's see what happens when they all build up. That's a pretty full roof. I think that it could use a little bit more help. So I'm gonna fill in these, but only on the s what? Only on the sides. Believe I could just have these come up like this. That goes straight out. And a little bit of this going on top. That'll connect to the stairs. Just like that. It'll look really nice. These balconies, I think that's about it. I've yet to determine what I'm gonna do with this. That's not too many balconies, is it? That's not a overboard on the ability to stand outside of the second floor of your house, right? Yeah, I'll put a few more roof pieces up there. Right. Oh. All right. When in doubt, put a big glass window in. And in fact, glass windows just make everything look better. And speaking of that, oh hey, look, all the buildings in here have windows now. And doors. But none of them are as fancy as the doors in that place. And in fact, if you recall earlier, the fact that I don't use the only reason I'm using oak and birch wood is because those are the only trees that are actually grown in this area. And stuff like spruce is a little bit more exotic and actually only exists on the other side of the wall, which is an area that is actually, there's a reason why the wall's there. It's supposed to be kind of a, I kind of mentioned it before a little bit. I haven't gone into detail, but essentially it's like the forbidden area outside of the lands, the safe areas inside. But interestingly enough, these are spruce door doors. I mean, spruce, whatever. These are spruce wood doors. And maybe an educated person would realize, well, wait a minute. Wait a minute. So, I don't know. I haven't decided yet if they're going to be the benevolent rulers of this land or the maleficent rulers. Malevolent? Malevolent or maleficent? Whatever. I'm also going off of the fanciness scale, and what that means is the fancier the building, the more important it is to the area. So like that looks really fancy. It's like absurdly fancy, actually. Oh, I didn't do any of the supports. Never mind. I guess I did. It's okay, everybody. The house is fine. It's got this one pillar here, so you don't have to worry. None of that. Worrying stuff. This is literally the least that I can do. Like, literally, this is the least. Actually, I should probably do more. All right, that's a little bit more substantial. Well, we're running out of time, so I think I'm gonna have to wrap things up here. But as you can see, we got pretty far. like the houses are in. I guess we did finish the village houses, but not the landscaping. I guess I'll have to wait till another time because I think that might be really a bit more in depth. But anyways, I'm pretty happy with how this is turning out so far. Oh yeah, there's also this. This is going to be an interesting spot. So, I want to get up here. There we go. So, as always, thank you for watching. This has been Red McNed, and I will hopefully see you in the next video.